Welcome to my second recording of a stay-at-home practice. I'm so glad that you're here. As we all work through these challenging, trying times, it's important that we keep ourselves grounded. And one of the ways for us to do that is to let go of whatever is tripping us up. So let's let go of our worries, at least for this next hour. Let's focus on some flowing that's going to help to open up the hips, a very common place for all of us to store tension. And let's just, as we let go of those things that are holding us back, let's invite into our space this wonderful, healing, positive energy. That's what I hope you'll find happens to you in this practice. Thank you for being here. Now let's get started. Welcome everyone to an at-home yoga practice. This practice is going to be about letting go of whatever's disturbing us mentally, and also letting go physically. So let's begin our practice coming into a comfortable seated position. You could come into Virasana, hero pose like I am. You could sit on a block here. You could sit on a blanket with the blanket underneath your heels. Come into whatever space works best for you, cross-legged, legs long. We want you to get comfortable. And then let's just take a quiet moment. Hands on the thighs, elbows in. Let's deepen our breath. Try counting to four on the inhales and four on the exhales. Let's do that a little bit longer, continuing to do those full inhales. And exhales. Please bring your hands together in prayer. Let's just take a moment to check in, set our intention for this practice. And if you don't know what that is, let's make it about just letting go. Letting go of whatever doesn't serve us so we can fill this space with things that do. Open your eyes. Let's interlace the fingers. Push those palms away. Get that stretch through the shoulders, the upper back. And then inhale, let's take both arms up to the sky. And then on exhale, let's bring the right hand down, left arm up and over, maybe a little elbow, a bend in that right elbow. And inhale, let's come back up, interlacing the fingers one more time, getting that big stretch. And then exhale. Let's bring the left hand down, right arm up and over. If you want to tent the fingers here, build a little strength in those fingers, this is a nice time to do that. And then inhale, let's come back up. This time let's reach for opposite elbows. Get a nice big stretch through that upper back. Working out some of that tension. And then exhale, hand comes down. Once again, you could tent the fingers here or you could come down into the elbow. But try to go a little deeper in the stretch. Inhale, let's take it back up. Do the reverse of what you did the first time. So whatever doesn't feel quite as natural. And then exhale, left hand comes down, little bend in that left elbow, right arm reaching up and over. Let's come back up. We're gonna make our way to a table pose, hands nice and flexed, knees under the hips. Let's warm up the spine with some cat-cows. So inhale, lift the chin, chest up. And then exhale, tuck the chin to the chest. Let's arch that back. Keep it going. Inhaling up. Exhaling, rounding the spine. Do a few more of these. Trying to connect the breath with the movement. So important that we warm up the spine. And then let's come back to a neutral table. We'll curl the toes, lift the hips, make our way into a down dog. Maybe bend the knees, stretching things out. Let's go ahead and walk the hands back to the feet and just sway a little from side to side, loosening things up. Letting the head be nice and heavy here so we get some length through that, the back of the neck. And then let's come back to a down dog. We'll lift the right leg up. And please step that right foot forward as far as you can to the top of the mat. You might want to kick back the back heel. Let's keep the left hand down and inhale. We'll take the right arm up to the sky, getting that nice stretch. One of the places we're going to spend a lot of time on our practice with today is opening up those hips. So, great place where we all store tension. And so we're going to focus much of our postures on helping to open that up. Let's lift the left leg up this time. And step that left foot forward to the top of the mat. We're in a runner's lunge. Right hand comes down. Inhale, let's take the left arm up. If you have a block and you prefer to use a block, it's a great option here. And then exhale, let's bring the left hand down. Let's step back to a down dog. And then let's take the hips down so that we are in a plank pose. Core is nice and strong here. Let's take it back to a down dog. Forward again to a plank. And then one more time, let's take it back. Let's come to the top of a push-up. I'm going to encourage most of you to lower down. Knees could be up or down. You're going to come down to the bottom of a push-up. And then inhale, roll to the tops of the feet for up dog. Try to relax the shoulders. Try to keep the gaze forward. Breath is more steady when we do that. And then exhale. Curl the toes. Lift the hips. Coming back to our down dog. Go ahead, lift the right leg again. Step that right foot forward. You're back in that runner's lunge. And then let's straighten out that right leg. Dip down. Let's lower the left knee as we do. Inhale, straighten out that right leg. Let's lower down that left knee. And once again, lift up. Lunge in, plant the hands, step back, down dog. This time left leg lifts. We'll step that left foot forward between the hands. Straighten out that left leg. Let's lunge into that left knee, and as you do, lower down that right knee. Inhale, lift up. Exhale, bring it down. Inhale up. Exhale down. Plant the hands. Make your way back. Down dog. Let's come forward to plank. Lower down, bottom of a push-up. And then inhale for up dog. I'm modifying here to address an injury. Exhale, curl the toes. Lift the hips, down dog. But please do your planks, your push-ups, your chaturangas, whatever works best for you. Inhale, let's take that right leg up. Let's draw that right knee to the right elbow. Inhale, take it back up. Right knee comes over to the left. Inhale up. Let's take that right foot forward between the hands. And then let's take it all the way up to a crescent warrior. If you want, lower down that left knee. Exhale, prayer, twist it. Left elbow hooking outside that right knee. You're pushing through that back heel. Exhale, let's bring the hands down. Let's take a quarter turn to the left. Halfway lift. Exhale, let's fold down. Inhale, let's lift up. Let's take those arms all the way up. Interlace those fingers. Look up. Let's open those arms. Interlace the fingers behind the back. Lift that chin up. Exhale, fold all the way down. Forward fold, arms reaching. And then exhale, let's bring the right hand over to the left heel, put a little bend in that left knee, and inhale, let's take that left arm up to the sky. Exhale, let's take that left hand over to the right heel, little bend in the right knee, and inhale, let's take the right arm up. Exhale, release. Bring the hands onto the hips. Inhale, roll all the way up. Head being the last to come up. Let's take those arms out to a T and let's come into this posture in a slightly different way. Let's take that right hand over to the left heel, lunge into the left knee, left arm reaches high. And then inhale, let's lift back up. Left hand over to the right heel, lunge into that right knee, left arm reaching high. Exhale, let's release. Let's turn so that our left foot is facing forward and we are on the ball of the right foot. We're lunging into that left knee. On an inhale, we're going to make our way up to a crescent warrior, maybe interlacing the fingers, elbows back behind the ears, breath strong. And then exhale, prayer twist, right elbow is going to come outside that left knee. You're kicking through that right heel. Exhale, let's bring both hands down. Let's take that quarter turn to the right. Halfway lift. Exhale, fold down. Hands on the hips. Inhale, let's lift all the way up. Let's turn that right foot forward and lunge into that right knee. Let's make our way to a warrior two. Maybe close the eyes and just check in. Let's flip that right palm. Let's make our way to a reverse warrior. Inhale, let's come back up, warrior two. Let's go ahead, straighten that right leg. Reach forward with that right hand. If you want to use a block here, it's a great option. I'm going to do a modified triangle because I'm protecting an injury. So right hand is down, left arm is up. For some of you, you're going to be able to reach that right hand all the way to the mat or to a block. Stay lifted and open here. And then let's extend that top arm over the head. Big stretch. Inhale, let's come back up. Please bring your hands together, heart center. Let's turn that right foot in. Let's just close our eyes. Check in. Settle in. Just notice what happens when we start to work out some of the physical tension. We're able to mentally let go of all that worry, all that chatter that brings disharmony to our lives. Please open your eyes when you're ready. Let's turn that left foot away from you, lunge into that left knee. Let's open up. We are in Warrior Two, gazes off that left hand, doing our best to keep our right arm up in alignment with the left. And then let's flip that left palm. Take that left arm up and over. We're in what we call a reverse warrior. Let's come back to warrior two. Straighten out that left leg. Left hand's gonna come down. Right arm's gonna lift up. Once again, doing our best to lean back, stay lifted and open. Know that this practice is about doing what's right for you, so let go of thinking it needs to look like somebody else's version. Extend the top arm over the head and do what feels right for you. If you find right now your back needs a little support, maybe place the hand on the thigh. And then inhale, come back up. Let's not forget to smile. Hands together, heart center. Left foot comes in. Let's make our way down to a forward fold, maybe threading the arms between the legs. Go ahead and turn that left foot away from you. So you're coming back into that runner's lunge. You're gonna actually walk that left foot off a little bit to the left side. See if we can bring the right forearm down and gently just push that left knee out a little bit to the side. This could be done with the right knee down. You might explore which option works best for you. But keep the top of the foot down if the knee is down, because that helps to relax the leg a little bit. This helps it keep it a little more energized. Exhale, release. Let's go ahead and bring that foot in a little bit so it's in front of the left hip. Let's try lifting up that right foot. Reaching back with that left hand, gaze off the shoulder. And you know what, if you can't bind the foot here, then just release it and extend the arm back behind you. Exhale, let's release. Both hands come down. Lift up that right knee. Let's take a quarter turn to the right. Turn that right foot out to the side. So we're coming back into this version over here of dragon pose. We're gonna walk that right foot off a little bit to the right side of the mat. Left foot comes down or stays up, your choice. Come down onto the forearm if you can. A block is a great tool here if you need a little extra height. And then gently push that right hand against that right knee. Keep that left foot down. Let's come back center. We're gonna make our way to a child's pose. So go ahead, take the knees mat width apart. Sink down to the heels. Let's actively extend those arms forward. So really reaching, you're getting a stretch through the upper back, drawing the forehead towards the earth. We'll take a few breaths here. When you're ready, inhale, let's lift up. I'm gonna bring those knees together. Let's make our way into a table pose again. And let's just take the hands off to the left side. Now as we do, sink the heels down towards the right. Feel that stretch through that upper arm, the armpit, the upper back. And then inhale, let's lift up. Let's take it over to the other side. Lunge down. Inhale, let's come back up. Hands on the mat, let's curl the toes, lift the hips. We're in a down dog. We're gonna lift that left leg up. We're gonna crunch that left knee to the left elbow. We did this on the other side earlier. Inhale, let's take it back up. Let's take that left knee over to the right. Inhale, let's step it up. Lift it up, let's set that left foot down beside the right. Let's make our way to a forearm plank. We're kicking through those heels. Powering up the core. And then let's try coming into a side forearm plank. Stack the foot onto left foot on top of the right if you can. Left arm reaches up, maybe extends over the head. Oops. We all fall out at one point or another. Another way to do this is to step one foot in front of the other. So if that's an option for you, you could also lower down the right knee. Exhale, let's bring it down. Sorry to have my back to you. We're going to roll up to the outer edge of the left. Right arm is up. Core is strong. Right arm extends. Exhale, both forearms come down. Let's try lowering the knees down. Come on the tops of the feet. Gaze is forward, but then tuck the chin just a little bit. Shoulders drop down. Be mindful of the breath here. We're trying to make sure the breath is steady and full. Sometimes if the neck's up too much, it restricts that air passage. And then let's transition to a child's pose, again, as a nice counterbalance. Feet are together this time. Hands down by the sides. Palms facing up. And then inhale, let's go ahead, come up. Let's do a couple of shoulder rolls. Reverse that direction. We're gonna come into a seated position. Starting with the left heel in close to the groin. Let's put a bend in the right knee and let's take our hands, interlace them around that right foot. I'm gonna tilt to the side so you'll be able to see this a little better. Extend that right leg up. So, and then maybe you can reach both hands towards the heel. If you cannot reach for the foot, try reaching for the calf. What we're trying to do is keep the, pull that right hip in a little bit, heart center forward. Breath is strong. We can strengthen and release some of the muscles in the hamstring. That will help us as we work towards some of these hip openers that we're transitioning in towards. And then exhale, let's release. Let's try bringing that right foot up to that left hip. And then we're gonna try taking the right hand behind the back, reaching for that right foot. If you can't reach the foot and hand is just behind the back, that's a great option. So just take a moment here, let's settle in. And then lift up that left arm. Let's try taking that left hand outside the right knee and using that hand and knee as some leverage, gaze off that right shoulder. So you're trying to turn with your heart, not your neck here. Breath is strong. Exhale, release. Let's shake the arm out. Let's extend both legs long. Now you might want, if you have a blanket close by, you might want to use it this just to sit and lift up the hips just a little bit. But what we're going to do is we're going to take the legs apart. A big V here. And then let's walk the hands forward. Please bring the hands together in a prayer and bow your head down. And then inhale, let's go ahead, lift up. You can either continue to sit on the blanket. For me, I find it works best. If I don't for this next thing, we're gonna take the right heel in, put a bend in the left knee. Once again, let's reach for that foot. So I'll turn myself a little bit so my foot's not in front. Interlace the fingers around that left heel if you can, just stretch out that leg. Keep the breath strong. Nothing more calming than the sound of your own breath, except maybe some birds. Let's go ahead and take that left heel close to the right hip flexor, and you can keep that bottom leg either long or you can keep it bent. It's your choice. This time the left hand's gonna come around, reach for that left foot. And once again, just take a moment here. You'll probably notice the torso start to shift a little bit to the left. You can go ahead and let that happen. And then inhale, let's take that right arm up. Exhale, right hand outside that left knee. Once again, turn the heart center off to the left. Exhale, release. Let's open both legs out again. Big stance here. Sitting up nice and tall. This time we'll bring that left forearm inside that left leg. Let's reach the left arm up, keep that right foot flexed, and extend that left arm over the head. big stretch through that left side. And then exhale, let's fold down over that right leg, maybe drawing the forehead towards the knee, maybe taking the left hand outside the right foot and right hand outside the other side of the foot and draw the forehead towards the knee. And then inhale, let's go ahead, lift up. Let's turn to the other leg. Left forearm is down. Hand could be on a block here if you prefer. Right arm reaching up and then arcing over the head. Right hand to the pinky side of the left foot, maybe the left hand to the big toe side of the foot, and draw the forehead towards the knee. Inhale, let's go ahead, lift up. Let's extend both legs long. Let's give them a little jingle. A little jiggle, not jingle. And then we're gonna do a couple more things for the hips. So let's start first. See if we can do maybe half lotus. So left foot on top of that right thigh, and then maybe the right foot on top of the left. This is where it's sometimes nice to have the blanket just to elevate those hips a little bit. Let's try bringing our hands together, heart center. Let's not forget to smile. And then let's just close our eyes. Give ourselves permission to settle in. Try to keep that smile on your face. Let's bring the fingertips down, tent those fingers, sit up nice and tall here. Let's untangle those legs. Give them another little jiggle, a little shake out. And then we'll do the opposite of what we did before. So we're gonna try taking the right foot over the left and the left foot comes on top of the right. And doing our best, whatever this looks like. Once again, this is an exercise in letting go. Let's honor where we're at in our bodies. We can't do it all, we can't do it all. But we are the best version of ourselves. Exhale, release. We'll do one more exercise for those hips. Just trying to help us let go of unnecessary tension, reach those arms high. Exhale, fold down. Let's just straighten out those legs. Maybe once again, left hand towards the pinky side of the right foot and right hand towards the left. Draw the head down. Keep the breath strong. To fire log. Once again, blanket is optional for elevating the hips. So we're gonna cross the left ankle above that right knee. Some of you will keep that bottom leg long. Some of you are gonna be able to take that right heel so that it's under that left knee. And let's just once again tent those fingers, draw back, opening up through the heart center. And then please bring your hands together, heart center. Close your eyes, settle in. If you'd like, you could come down to a forward fold, either reaching with those arms, or maybe bringing the hands together in prayer. And then inhale, let's go ahead, lift up. Before we do the other side, let's go ahead, extend those legs. Let's point and flex those feet. And then this time we're gonna cross the right ankle above the left knee. Left heel comes in. Once again, you could extend the bottom leg long if you'd like. Bring those fingers out to the side. If you find that you need a little support here, you could always bring your blanket under your knee or even under your foot. So always an option. Let's take those arms high. Exhale, hands together, heart center. Just allow yourself to settle in. Feel this space. Connect with your breath. Let go of your worries and know that you are in a perfect space right now. And then exhale, if you wish, fold down, forward fold. Go ahead and extend both legs long. We're going to make our way onto our backs. You might want to have your blanket handy, and I'll show you why in a moment. Right now, just come onto your backs, get comfortable. And draw the knees into the chest. Hug those knees in tight. Gently rock a little from side to side. Let's lift the legs up to the sky and take them apart to a big V. Let's reach those arms over the head, elbows back behind the ears. And then inhale, let's draw those arms between the legs. And exhale, bring it down. Inhale, lift up. Exhale, bring it down. If you prefer, you could also do this with the soles of the feet down. Inhale, up. Exhale, down. Inhale, up. Exhale, down. Whichever version works best for you, let's go ahead, take five more on our own. Let's hear that breath. Let's do our best to smile, inviting in whatever we're offering into this practice. Let's do one more. And then exhale, come back down onto your back. Reach for your feet or your ankles. Let's keep the knees wider than the hips and the feet wider than the knees. Sometimes it's nice to rock a little bit from side to side here. We're in happy baby pose. It's a great hip opener, great release for tension in the low back and the hip area. Also a beautiful way to quiet the central nervous system. And doing that, we do two things. We set ourselves up for Shavasana, but we also helps to energize us. So hopefully you'll leave this practice feeling a little more restored and refreshed. Exhale, let's go ahead, draw those knees into the chest, give them a big hug. And then let's bring the soles of the feet down to the mat. We're gonna lift the butt, the hips up, maybe interlacing the fingers and rolling up onto those shoulders, trying to lift those hips as high as you can. And then exhale, you'll lower down. Please bring those knees into your chest. Give yourself a big hug. Let's go ahead and extend that left leg long. Flex the foot. Let's take that right knee over to the left side. Right arm comes out to a T. And we're gazing off the right shoulder. Close your eyes, settle in. Need a little support here, you could always bring the blanket under the knee. If this is too intense of a stretch, you could also bend the bottom knee and just do a spinal twist that way. Let's come back center and we'll switch it up. Right leg is going to extend long. The left arm comes out to the side, and that right hand guides that left knee over to the left. This time you'll be gazing off the left shoulder. If you're ever not sure where to go in these poses, just close your eyes and check in. Honor what's going on with your own body. It's amazing what we can figure out in terms of how we need to modify when we do check in. Come back center. Let's extend both legs long down the mat. Feet out to the side, hands down by the sides. Let's do a cleansing breath here. Big inhale through the nose. Exhale. Let's try that again. Big inhale. Thank you. Let's start to bring a little movement back to the body. So try bringing the toes together and then take them back out to the sides. Toes in, toes out. Let's do it again. Let's take it out. Let's reach those arms over the head and point those feet. And then let's draw the knees into the chest. Please roll over to the right side. Just take a moment here. And when you're ready, let's make our way to a comfortable seated position. It could be cross-legged, it could be Virasana hero pose that we did at the beginning. Could be another version of half lotus. Let's bring our hands together, heart center. Let's bow our heads. Let's honor this beautiful practice of letting go of physical tension so that we can also let go mentally of whatever is tripping us up. Let's bring our hands to our mind's eye, middle of the forehead. Om Shanti, Namaste. Thank you. Have a great day.